Well, what's up, beginner guys? Brian here at 3TR, and welcome to another standard issue of my weekly Q&A here, Top Tables Questions, episode, I believe, 237. We've got actually much shorter episode than we did last week, which that episode was actually surprisingly short. But I believe we got questions from mostly all regulars with a few or a couple of newbies this time around. So coming right off with the first question coming from a constant regular of mine, going by the name of JDS4696, and you want to know, do I think I will eventually get the PlayStation VR? Probably not. It just seems like a really crazy gimmick. I've never really been into the whole concept of virtual reality. But I'll have my opportunity to test it firsthand very soon. I got a little bit of a special announcement that I'll do maybe in a few weeks, but I don't want to spoil it too much, but I'll definitely give it a try. But I'm pretty sure I won't be really dishing out the cash in order to actually go pick it up to get my own, you know, unit of it, so probably unlikely. Next question comes from K Carrot, and you want to know, which of these is a cheap way of doing a plot? Multiverse or time travel? Well, they're both cheap. Time travel, you kind of have to establish your own set of rules because there are multiple different versions of time travel, as far as I'm concerned. And multiverse, I guess, is a little bit more complicated because the whole idea of multiverse is really done with the idea of choice. How, you know, every time a decision is made, it spawns two different verses. So, depending on how important the choice is or how important the event is, you really could have an infinite number of different multiverses. So I guess time travel is a little bit cheaper because really all you have to worry about is time paradox, which, you know, could wipe out the entire universe, as Doc Brown would say. So I'd say they're equally cheap. They just both have different levels of flawness, I would say. Your next question comes from, I believe, the first newbie, going by the name of ArcaneMagic514, and you want to know, which game is worse, 13 or DMC? Oh, jeez. You gotta bring up two games on my blacklist. Okay, listen, I may shit all over DMC and think it's crap and think it's well-deserving of, I believe, the 2.5 score rating I would give it, but I stated one thing about that game that I guess was semi-positive, and that is that it's playable. That's more than I can say for 13, which is completely unplayable. So, yeah, I mean, heck, once I put the game on mute and listen to my own music, I got through it. It's playable. That's all I can say for it. The next question comes from, I believe, this seems like you're familiar to me, but I'm not sure. Going by the name of Thomas Haar. And he wants to know, which of these PlayStation mascots do you think is the best? Crash Bandicoot, Spyro, Jack and Dexter, Ratchet and Clank, or Sly Cooper? I'm very fond of Ratchet and Clank. Ratchet and Clank was actually the very first game I ever played on the PlayStation 2. I think it's probably one of the best games that has come out this year, because I absolutely fell in love with it. The movie, I guess, is definitely for fans, even though I know it bombed pretty hard in the box office. But, yeah, I would definitely say Ratchet and Clank are the best. Everybody else is, you know, they're a good mascot of their time. I mean, we haven't really had a good Spyro or Crash, a new Spyro or Crash game in some time. Jak and Dexter is just a little bit too out there for me. And Sly is probably a good second place, but there's no replacing Ratchet and Clank, at least for me. The next question comes from Macho Wesker, and you have another Mortal Kombat question for me. Well done. And you want to know, what is it about Mortal Kombat that appears more to be compared to other fighting games? Okay, I think it's the fact that Mortal Kombat probably has the best collection of characters. You can kill people and look good doing it. I think it probably has the most interesting story. I know that something like Street Fighter has a story, but it's not quite as interesting. It's just the fact that, you know, games like King of Fighters or Dead or Alive or Tekken or Killer Instinct, they have their collection of colorful characters, but it, to me, just has never felt too consistent. Mortal Kombat has always managed to reach this kind of bar of entertainment for the most part. I think they've had maybe a couple of flops in terms of trying to venture off from its typical gameplay style, which I don't think that's something that any of the other fighting games have tried, but it's the fact that it has attempted to break out of its stereotypical game style. Even if it's failed, I give the developers at NetherRealm Studios, or at the time back then, Midway, for actually attempting to do something new with this property. And that's more than I can say for something like Street Fighter or Tekken or Dead or Alive or King of Fighters. So I think that's why Mortal Kombat has always appealed more to me. Plus, you can't go wrong with Scorpion and Sub-Zero. They trump everybody. The next question comes from Sansco Scarpino, and he wants to know, is there anything I liked about the two... Oh, Jesus. Two times in the same video? I'll say it again. The game was fucking playable. That's it. I was able to beat it from beginning to end. I had to kind of alternate my own personal experience by playing, you know, one, it wasn't Dante and Virgil. It was Bob and his bullshit brother Steve. The plot made no sense, so it's just kill everything in sight. And every time some action came on, I just put on my own Linkin Park or Disturbed or Skillet or hell, Metallica. Put my earbuds on, and played it. That's it. It's playable. You can beat it. I guess you could say that with a lot of games like Tetris. Or hell, Superman 64. Hell, that's playable. I've beaten that. As frustrating as that was. Even that is better than 13. So yes. There. Does that answer your question? And that's one thing I could say is good about DMC. It's playable. And with that, that is the last question of the episode. I'd like to thank most of you for sending in your questions. If you guys have any more questions you'd like me to answer in next week's episode, please be sure to make sure they are not related to DMC or 13. But if you like this video, feel free to like and comment down below, but make sure you get your questions into me by next Wednesday before I start filming this. And like always, I want to thank you guys, and I will see you next time. Please, no more 13 or DMC questions. Please.